Everybody is blaming Grayscale or the Grayscale Bitcoin Trust for suppressing the price since the Bitcoin ETF approval. But is this really what's going on here? Is Grayscale the reason why Bitcoin cannot move higher from here? And the most important question of all, how long can this potentially continue? Let's have a look at the in and outflows into Bitcoin ETFs. Have a look at this. This is different Bitcoin spot ETFs. And at the bottom, we've got the Grayscale Bitcoin Trust that converted from a trust to an ETF. Now we're seeing a lot of inflows with BlackRock's iShares ETF getting most of the inflows. But we also see a lot of outflows, 7.6 billion from the Grayscale Bitcoin Trust. In the first 6 days since the Bitcoin launch, $6.4 billion went net into the ETFs. So does the Grayscale selling suppress the price? Yes, it might. But net, the effect of the ETFs had been positive. And the big question is really, is this simply people getting out of Bitcoin altogether? Or are people rather converting from Grayscale to another ETF because these other ETFs have lower fees? I think it's rather the second. The Grayscale Bitcoin Trust has the highest fees, and so there's really no need to be exposed to those high fees if you can also simply just own something owned by BlackRock. Early buyers now will make millions. That's how you get clicks on YouTube, but that's not necessarily how you really make money. The way to make money with crypto is to be more skilled than others, to know more than others, to do blockchain analytics better than others. It's the boring technical content that doesn't do well on YouTube, but that forms skills and that I offer in the premium membership. So there's a lot of tutorials over there, how I approach analyses. And if you join, you also get direct access to me. You can ask me any questions and I reply as fast as I can. We are still below 100 people, so I do have enough time to reply everyone. Feel free to check it out. It's thebitcoinstrategy.com. Now, there are some talks around potentially creating paper Bitcoin, right? Because there's now the ETF. This could mean that all of this purchasing power that would have gone directly into Bitcoin now go into the ETF. And maybe the ETFs don't really hold that balance. I don't think that's true, because the ETFs in their nature have to settle the balance between inflows and outflows at the end of every trading day with Coinbase. That's in the end the whole idea of a Bitcoin spot ETF. We already had a Bitcoin futures ETF in the past, right? Where you could simply just bet on the price of Bitcoin. But now with a Bitcoin spot ETF, you now have to settle at the spot market. So what is it then that caused that 20% decline in the price in the last few days? It might have been people that simply just speculated on that ETF approval. A classic buy the rumor, sell the news event. But people that did make those trades, probably in the vast majority, have now sold. I don't believe there's a lot of investors that buy the rumor and sell the news 1 month after the news has occurred. And so I think it's most likely, if we don't get any massive bearish news now, that Bitcoin can recover from the current level. This is probably a pretty good buy the dip opportunity. I don't have a crystal ball either. I'm simply just trying to make good guesses. And I try to hold Bitcoin for as long as possible, because in the end, that's what happens. Bitcoin is limited in supply, fiat is not. And so over time, of course, the fiat valuation of Bitcoin will rise. The question is just, how long does it take? As the saying goes, when in doubt, zoom out. And over the long term, Bitcoin is simply just a mechanism to transfer money from the impatient to the more patient. So simply just expand your time horizon. If you're new here, feel free to subscribe. I publish videos regularly. A like would be very much appreciated as well. It helps the channel grow. There's also a free Telegram. Link is down below.